Hey babe, we are going to the store, and I'm going to get 6 beers,
okay.
And I'm going to prove to you, one of them's going to be a Corona, but I'm going to prove to you that there's no difference between the beers I drink and your so-called perfect Corona.
Let's just get to the part of the bet.
The bet is I'm not going to see Dwight Yoakam for the 6th time.
And I'm going to see Dwight with you if I pick out the Corona out of the 6 beers.
There's no way. With a blind test, you're not going to pick a Corona out. You think Corona is so distinctive that you'll know
it.
But that's because you've seen the bottles and you've seen the beers and you've seen the price.
What does the bottle have to do with it?
It's your eyes, babe. It's your mind.
Oh, you know what?
Your mind and your eyes are corrupted.
You're going to see. You're going to be sitting down there at Maymont Park, people. Go to Maymont Park. You're going to see Dwight on the 28th of August in Virginia, Richmond, Virginia. And we're going to be sitting there, and Poppy's going to be doing dim lights, thick smoke.
It's not going to happen.
You're going to do it, babe.
It's not going to happen. Babe, with this bet, when you can't see the Corona bottle, or feel the smoothness of that top of that Corona bottle with your nasty little lips.
That's crazy. They all have smooth tops.
No, the Corona bottle is actually different than any other beer bottle out there.
You got that right.
Right, and that's what you're. And that's why you like that smooth, round bottle on your nasty little lips.
I love Corona.
Yeah. Well, if you can't feel the bottle, you ain't gonna be able to pick it out.
Watch and see. You're going to see the white yoga.
And when I'm right, what I win is you will never, ever, ever tell me Corona is the number one beer ever. Because she says she can pick a Corona out of 6 beers. Not if I'm picking the 6 beers. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Let's do it. I set this up for Little Miss Muffet. I got the bags to cover the bottles, the glasses with bags on so she can't see the beer color, and a little welcome sign for.
I'm gonna prove you wrong on 2 points. I'm gonna prove you wrong on 1, where the Corona's not distinctive, and 2, the bet is, if you can pick the Corona out, we go into another Dwight Yoakam concert.
Yes, we are.
But if you can't pick the Corona out, not only you're not going to the Dwight Yoakam concert, but you can't talk about it at all until you can't even talk about up until concert time that you're not going. That's a deal, ain't it?
That's a deal.
And the only thing I win on this challenge is proving you that Corona does not have a distinctive taste. So you ready for this challenge? All right.
Let the party begin.
Well, let's get the beers and see which beers we're going to compare first. All right. Now, I was going to get a Pacifico, but they didn't have it. So we got a Stella Artois. We have a Corona. We have a Dos Equis Lager. We have a Modelo. We have a St. Pauli Girl Lager. And the beer that I drink 99% of the time when I'm not drinking home brews and I'm not out having drafts, Miller High Life. Miller, just plain Miller. That's going to be it in the mix too. So you ready for this challenge?
I'm ready.
All right, turn your seat around. And no peeking. No listening. I'll make you put headphones on so you can't hear the bags. What do you think?
My headphones is in there, my brain.
All right, well, you're not going to be able to know which beers I pick first anyway. All right. I'm going to pop all the tops at once so you can't tell which beers are being popped. This is going to be good. Gonna be good. I got bags around the glasses so you can't see the color. And I got these big, tall, deep glasses we bought yesterday.
So I can't smell it.
Well, you can smell it all you want.
California all gonna look the same.
You're not getting them mixed up, are you?
Babe? I'm pouring one at a time, putting it behind the bags. They all are identical. They all are identical. Can you tell anything by the sound of the pour?
No.
One more. And oh, we forgot to mention that whatever beer you choose is the Corona. If it's not the Corona, you have to drink it anyway. Remember that?
Yes, I remember
that. We did discuss that.
That's a nasty part of it.
All right, turn your seat around. You can start with whatever one you want, but I would start with number one and work my way down.
Number one's a lemonade, it's definitely not Corona.
It's a what?
It's definitely not Corona.
I thought you said it was a lemon in it.
No.
So this one's definitely not.
That's a lemonade.
A lemonade.
That's the first one.
All right.
Two, lemonade, it's definitely not a Corona.
Are you sure? Okay, two's a lemonade. They're getting going to be tougher. The first two were easy.
All right, I need to cleanse the palate.
It's going to get tougher.
My lucky number.
Six?
Yeah,
my favorite number. Well, let's hope for your sake. These are going to be your default. This is going to be
six
your fault.
Six is definitely out.
Six is out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cleanse again.
But I thought you said Corona was so distinctive you could pick it.
Because I've tasted so many different ones now.
All right. Don't want you to get excited now. Lemonade?
Yeah, lemonade.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Alright. You're down to two. Which one's the Corona?
Number three.
Number three is the Corona.
Let me try one more time.
Those three, you've done eliminated six, so you really eliminated three, too. I know my beers. This is going to be a tough challenge. I live beer. Three's out still?
I'm taking five.
You're taking five. All right, let's see the ones you didn't take. One was Miller.
I knew Miller weren't it.
The beer I drink 90% of the time because it's cheap. 18 of them for $10. Two was Dos Equis Lager. Three, which you almost chose as
Corona
was St. Pauli Girl German Lager.
It's close.
It is close. Let's see, six was the next one you eliminated it. Eliminated it. Eliminated was Modelo. Four and five are left.
Four and five is my chocolate.
Now, one of these beers between four and five is my favorite beer, Stella. One's a Corona, one's a Stella.
I still think four is a Corona, but you're not going to let me go back to let them choose five.
I'll let you change. Remember now, Dwight Yoakam concert's on the line. I think I would stick with my palate if I was choosing, but you can change if you like.
I keep my five because I feel like it'd be cheap.
Number four, which is throwing you, which you think could be Corona, is Stella Artois.
I got it!
Key Corona is Stella Artois.
I got it!
Almost didn't do it. You almost chose my favorite beer, Stella Artois. You almost chose it. Tell me Stella don't throw you. Stella tastes just like a Corona. And St. Pauli Girl tastes just like a Corona, too.
I had drank these so much, what got me? I knew the Corona was a little bit bitter, but that has a little bitter taste to it, too.
Stella is awesome. Stella. Stella. Now let's look at the colors. Look. St. Pauli Girl, Stella, and Corona are absolutely identical. You were pretty close. You almost.
Stella's got that kind of like bittery taste like Corona has.
Alright, so for the famous Corona Beer Challenge, I lost and you won.
And where are you going?
To see Dwight Yoakam again.
When is this?
August 28th. So, for Tom's Beer Channel, I'm Tom Moore.
Good luck to you.
Yeah, good luck to us all.